So I've had the opportunity to mess around with the Insta360 Ace Pro action camera, and I've actually used it on a few shoots. One was actually on the release of a new sports car called the Rizvani Beast. This camera was such a joy to use when shooting that commercial. I'm officially happy with the picture quality coming out of an action camera coming from Insta360. Now, I've had the Go 3, the Go 2. Those things had really good image quality, much better than the X2 and sometimes even better than the X3. But when it came down to overall picture quality coming from, let's say, the 1R or 1RS, Insta360 wasn't on the GoPro par for that quality, but now it is. Using the Ace Pro's flat profile, I'm able to color grade and add LUTs really easily. And these LUTs are coming in from Motion Array, and they are sponsoring this portion of today's video. They offer a ton of cool royalty-free assets, such as dust elements, videos, photos, music. I'm able to create some really cool video effects and videos in general using their assets. As you can see here, a lot of them are as easy as drag and drop, and I just love going through their catalog and browsing through all the things that they have on their website. Make sure that you check out the link down below in the description box. Sign up today and you'll get $50 off the annual plan. I highly recommend it because they have a ton of things that can make your videos stand out. Their templates and motion graphics and plugins work with all video editors such as Adobe Premiere and even Final Cut Pro. So you can just download them, install them, and instantly start using them. So again, make sure you check out the link down below and explore Motion Array today. And we get beautiful stabilization. And on top of that, this is now a vlogging camera because of the awesome mic quality, this cool flip-out LCD display that's also touchscreen. And I just love the overall build quality of this thing too, because it feels rugged, it doesn't feel cheap. None of the plastic feels like it's gonna squeeze or break on me. So I really love what they've done with this camera. On top of that, they've released a ton of different accessories, a lot of which I used on the car shoot that I did for filming the Rizvani Beast. I used some of their sticky mounts or suction cup mounts. I've also used this camera going on vacation, going on road trips. I've captured so much content with this thing, and it just constantly wowed me with its great picture quality, ease of use, and even the battery life. We also have a data screen up here at the front, so you get to know how much space is left on your card, you know, how long it's been recording for, what resolution you're recording in, and so forth. And then obviously, since the screen flips up like that and you can film yourself, there's no need to have another screen like that in the front of the camera. And yes, they do make an ND filter set for this camera. But besides the point, on the bottom of the camera, we have a magnetic base, which means that this can work with a ton of different accessories, such as this universal mount, which also has a built-in 1/4-20-inch screw thread. This will work with many action camera mounts, even coming from different brands. And it's a strong magnet, so it just, boom, clicks right into place. There's even a little lock here at the bottom, and it just works really, really well. One of the things that I really worried about when using an action camera like the Ace Pro was the low light imagery. And on this thing, it's pretty good. They have a specific setting called Pure Video. When enabled, it drops the resolution to 4K max. And you can notice that the images become much brighter in darker situations. Noise is limited, but there is some noise there, so be careful of that. But I do highly recommend using this camera in well-lit environments, especially since you're gonna get 8K, so that full resolution out of this sensor. And this will allow you to crop in and get tighter shots if need be. But overall, the sharpness coming from this camera is very impressive. I mean, I used it for a commercial shoot. That should tell you something, right? Also, when you flip this camera vertically, just like on the Go 3, it instantly turns into vertical video, perfect for Instagram content. And I love their new little selfie stick tripod mount. This thing is tiny when folded up, and when extended, you can use it as a selfie stick and you can set it down basically anywhere. And this was especially useful when I needed to shoot BTS videos of me using a gimbal, let's say, or if I just wanted to film myself having a good time on a boat. So yeah, definitely loved using that tripod mount. Another useful mount that I used was the chest mount. And when I ride my electric unicycle, it's really fun to just boom, put this camera on my chest and get that full 8K 30 frames per second out of this camera and just share it to social media. It's just a lot of fun to do. Now, comparing this camera to the Go 3, we're just gonna talk about the overall size. The size of this camera is significantly bigger when it comes down to the screen size. The overall build quality, this feels definitely tougher simply because it's just one solid build. The Go 3 splits off into a smaller camera, so it's not gonna be as rugged. Also, this thing as a whole is waterproof, while the Go 3 is not waterproof when it's attached to its action pod. Now, I'm mainly a video guy, but just so you know, this thing has a ton of other video and photo options, such as star lapses, time lapses. You can take some really great shots with those as well. And there's also a new AI animation feature, which I'll cover in a future tutorial. This thing can transform any standard video into an AI masterpiece. So that's a really cool feature within the Insta360 app. And if you're filming a lot by yourself, you can set this up on a tripod or that selfie stick. Simply bring up your hand like this, and it will enable that gesture control feature and it will start recording. And of course, I recommend getting the Insta360 microphone adapter, especially if you're filming a lot of videos with this camera and you want the audio to be the best. This allows you to do a lot. So definitely pick one of those up. So that is my overall user experience with the Insta360 Ace Pro. It's a fabulous camera. I love it. So if you're interested, check out the link down below. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you in another one. Peace.